Hello, my name is Justin, and this is Merc in Arms.
Forged in fire, baptized in blood, and always gets the job done. The Stark Wrench, also called the Ullman Build-Matic, is based off a railroad monkey wrench. Originally designed in 1858 by Charles Monkey, the wrench was named after its creator with an intentional alteration of the spelling. Mr. Monkey's invention was most commonly used by railroads for locomotive repair for several decades as the tool they'd use when nothing else worked. It's fitting, then, that Dill, the engineer, uses a monkey wrench on his variety of buildings, which would undoubtedly need a variable tool to be useful on all of them. Now, let's get into the nuts and bolts of this tool of terror. The wrench has a base damage of 65 and a swing speed of once per every 0.8 seconds, which is the standard for melee weapons in TF2. Without any damage modifiers, it takes 2 swings to kill a scout and 7 swings to kill an overhealed heavy. In other words, it's great if you need to quickly react to an empty gun, but you can't really go around the battlefield rampaging with it. That's what the demo knife is for. But if the wrench isn't that effective in combat, what is it used for? The main purpose of the wrench is to, what else? Build and repair things. When you place a building as an engineer, it costs metal, which you can see your supply of in the bottom right-hand corner of the screen by default. You can get more metal by visiting the resupply locker at spawn or by picking up ammo packs. To build, simply press 4 and then the corresponding number to whichever building you wish to construct. Once you place the building, you can walk away and let it construct on its own time. However, it's much more effective to boost the building, which is done by repeatedly hitting it with your wrench. Once your building is fully built, you can upgrade it by continuing to swing, where you'll see a meter on the upper left of your screen next to that building's icon slowly going up as you make progress to the next level of your building, at a cost of 25 metal per swing, except in pregame where it costs 50 metal per swing. Buildings get exponentially more useful the more you upgrade them. Whole games can sometimes be entirely determined by whether your teleporter is a level 2 or a level 3, so take care to upgrade them any chance you get. But building and upgrading isn't the only thing the wrench can do, far from it. Your sentry gun uses up an internal ammo supply when it fires, and while it can certainly last a while, a minimum of 27 seconds of continuous fire, it does eventually run out. However, you can replenish the ammo of your sentry gun by hitting it with your wrench at a rate of 1 metal per bullet and 2 metal per rocket salvo. But it doesn't end there. Your buildings will, over the course of a round, take damage from enemy players. You can repair your buildings by hitting them with your wrench or firing rescue ranger bullets. With a repair rate of up to 34 HP per swing, you'll be done with the repair with time to spare. Finally, the wrench can be used to remove spy sappers from your buildings. The stock wrench can remove a sapper in 2 swings, whereas all other wrenches either match this rate or take extra swings to remove sappers. Now let's look at the rest of the tools you'll have equipped. As engineer, I suggest using the stock shotgun and stock pistol. I know I'll get people disagreeing with me, but I truly believe this is the best loadout for the stock wrench. The shotgun is the pinnacle of reliable, steady damage with a low skill floor and incredibly high skill ceiling. Capable of being reloaded incrementally rather than by magazine, you can reload individual shots into your gun for more flexibility mid-fight without sacrificing damage output, metal cost, or relying on gimmicks. All in all, it's a wonderfully versatile and useful tool for any engineer's arsenal. Next, what would any red-blooded Texan be without his pistol? Honestly though, the pistol is a reliable sidearm for almost any situation. It's the only weapon for that slot, which is always useful, and it has an ammo reserve even a day one Gibbous Vision would have a hard time eating through. For this loadout, your role is to be the anchor of defense while maintaining the firepower needed to survive on your own if your buildings go down during a push. While I highly recommend watching Uncle Dane's content for some incredibly in-depth guides on playing engineer at a higher level, let's go over some basics. With this loadout, your main goal is to get your buildings placed and upgraded as quickly as possible in team-supporting positions. That's right, no turtling for you. You have enough firepower to take down serious threats, and while you probably won't solo a heavy medic combo, you can still do a great deal of damage. However, most importantly, this loadout focuses on self-preservation. Buildings get destroyed, it's a fact of life. But if you can survive, you can rebuild. And a living NG with a level 1 is much more useful than a dead NG with a level 2. As for buildings, your top priority should always be to get at least a level 2 teleporter up and running as quickly as possible. Yes, a sentry gun is worth more than one player, but getting your entire team to the front line as quickly as possible benefits the whole team. Your next priority depends on variables like if you're attacking or defending. However, generally, I like to place my dispenser, grab ammo, place my sentry, focus on upgrading it to level 2, then focus on getting my dispenser to level 3. Once everything else is level 3, I then focus on my sentry, since the jump from level 2 to level 3 has the lowest return on investment. Once your gear is built, look for any areas that your team naturally gravitates to, such as a choke point or by a medkit, and place your dispenser there. Your dispenser has the power to turn a very untenable position into an easy anchor point for your team as well. Keep a lookout for places where, if there were a dispenser there, your team would be able to hold out. The Engineer is the only class that has the ability to on-the-spot terraform the map. Use this to your advantage. Yes, a dispenser can be your saving grace if a coordinated push reaches your sentry gun, but a coordinated push is far less likely to reach that far if you have your dispenser in a good place. Your teleporter is one where you have a good bit of freedom in placement, but in general the criteria I have when deciding if a spot is good are as follows. 1. Is it worth waiting a second or two in line to take this teleporter rather than walking? If it's not worth the wait, it's most likely not worth the metal it costs to place it. 2. Is this going to get taken down extremely quickly? If a teleporter only lasts 10 seconds, you wasted a lot of time in metal building. Never put a teleporter in a sniper's line of sight or out in the open. If you pass both of these criteria, go for it. Finally, for your sentry gun. Your sentry should never be the front line. That's what your DPS class is and heavier for. Rather, the sentry is best used as a fallback line. For example, it's far better to have your sentry near the point on Mercenary Park than it is to have it out in the foyer. Your team can stay fluid and keep pressure on the enemy team while your sentry gives a zone of relative safety to anyone who needs to fall back, while also serving as a stopgap if your team gets rolled and the enemy pushes in. As with any tool, the wrench is made for a specific job. And while the monkey wrench has a history of being the tool you use when nothing else works, in game, it's a slightly different story. There are certain scenarios where the wrench simply isn't feasible, such as playing offense on payload maps or on 5CP. With a frontline constantly in flux, the slow-paced defensive barrier that is the stock wrench is simply the wrong tool for the job. On these games, I suggest either using the Jag or the Gunslinger. The wrench. Solid, steady, always ready. Tune in next time when we'll be going over the scattergun. It'll be real good fun. And until then, hit shots, play smart, and try not to die.